Elemental hero, vision hero, destiny hero, evil hero. What do these things all have in common? Questionably tight clothing. Hi guys, it's Joe here from Rufioh. Welcome to the channel. If this is your first time here, welcome aboard. You should definitely hit subscribe and the notification bell before you realise how fucking bad this content is. And if this is not your first time on the channel, you may want to give your head a fucking wobble. But in either case, thank you very much for coming along. I do appreciate you being here. As you very well know, if you are a channel regular, we are currently on a slew of deck profiles. Currently, that weird shit that's going on in the world that I can't say without getting demonetized is kind of drying the well a little bit. For today's deck profile, we are taking a look at Omni-HERO. The spandexy boys with about 20 million different archetypes all smashed the fuck into one. These are a bit of a cult following deck, so I'm sure if you're here watching this, you are probably one of those guys. Well, if you are, then today's video is absolutely for you. If you are someone who is considering picking up the deck, or maybe you're just looking for Yu-Gi-Oh! Singles in general, you should check out the channel sponsors Jam Cards UK. There is a link in the description to their eBay store, and you'll get yourself a nice cheeky discount, courtesy of yours truly. On top of that, they don't just do Yu-Gi-Oh! Singles, they do Pokemon ones as well. But anyway, that's enough waffling on from me, let's get stuck in to the deck profile. So let me first start off by apologising if there is a weird whirring sound in the background. That is probably my laptop fans going absolutely fucking crazy. Hopefully though we'll be able to edit those out and this will all go plain sailing. As one final quick note before we get started, it is worth noting that the whole hero archetype seems to be pretty much a solved deck. There's actually very little that changes in here, maybe occasionally a little bit here and there on ratios, so you may see some difference there, but honestly, if you go out there and you look at most hero decks that are out there, being profiled and that kind of thing at the moment, you'll probably see something very similar to this. Usually the only time you see too much in the way of changes is it's normally a budget concern, or maybe someone playing something a little bit spicy for a locals or something like that. But for the most part, again, this deck seems to be a bit solved, so this will be a little bit cookie cutter and I won't dwell too much on anything that I'm going through, so expect a kind of just a rough rundown. So we start off with triple copies of Stratos. I don't know why this was fucking limited and banned and all that good stuff for so long. But honestly, triple copies of Stratos, I think you need to play it. Some people will occasionally play less, which I really don't understand. I think, apart from the fact that it searches stuff, which is really important, the fact that it searches any hero, which is also really important, is the fact that it helps deal with back row, something that is very heavy in the current format. As such, I think 3 is mandatory. And on top of that, everyone fucking loves Stratos. We've got a vision hero boys here, triple copies of Faris and double increase. If you know the combos and if you don't, go out and check those out. I won't be covering them in this video, but absolutely go and check those out and figure out how this works. But these are, well, they go hand in hand and nobody cares about many of the other vision heroes. So these are the two that you'd opt to play, playing 3 copies of Faris and 2 copies of increase. Running double Shadow Mist here again. I've seen this at 3 in some lists. I think 2 is perfectly fine. Obviously, this is going to help you get into your mass change, which is what it's primarily used for. But it does need to be special summoned in order for that to happen. So, unfortunately, seeing this in your hand as your normal summon is not ideal. We then move on. We have double copies of Malicious. This card is still too strong in this deck not to play it, even at 2. Sure, you don't get the same kind of advantage that you did before, but it's still a very, very strong card and one that you need to be using in the deck. Unfortunately, you already know how this ends, though. You will open probably one, if not both, copies in your fucking opening hand every game. Vision Hero Vion does all the deck thing you could absolutely need. The fact that it sends, does its whole Armageddon Knight-like effect on normal or special summon is absolutely awesome. I think 2 copies is perfectly fine, though. Again, you ideally want to be special summoning this as part of your combo rather than normal summoning it, but it's not the worst option in the world if this is what you open with. Running a single copy of Decider here, this just helps you recycle resources. It's not a massive important piece in the deck, but it is one that works quite nicely. Solid Soldier is really good, especially if you open it with things like Shadow Mist that otherwise wouldn't get their effects. You can benefit from using that. There's also the fact that it helps build back up your board when it's sent to the grave off a spell effect. Liquid Soldier is too strong again not to play if you've got access to it. I know that it's quite an expensive and rare card to get hold of, but if you do have access, one that you absolutely want to run. It's going to help you dig in a deck that can occasionally suffer with bricking. It can help unclog your hand by dumping stuff. If you see the likes of Malicious stuck in your hand, this can help you get rid of them. So there's a lot of little things that this does that kind of go understated. We have a single copy of Honest Neos. Honestly, the amount of times I absolutely fucked when I play against another hero player and this motherfucker gets dropped out of their hand, I goddamn hate it, but it is a little bit too strong not to play. It gives you a really good option. Sometimes your ending board turn one can be a little bit lackluster, and this can be the difference between whether you survive the turn or not. If your opponent doesn't have a way to out your monsters and they need to destroy it in battle, and they know you've got this in hand, they are absolutely fucked. Destiny Hero Plasma is an absolute cuck of a card. Really, you only want the one copy because you want to be either searching it or whatever, but honestly, it's incredibly strong. The downside, of course, is that you need to tribute three cards to get it out onto the field, but in this deck, you can swarm the field relatively quickly, and honestly, once this is out, a lot of decks can actually really, really struggle to deal with this. Destiny Hero Celestial can be really, really good. This deck has a habit of just vomiting your hand onto the field and hoping for the best. And this can give you a way to get back into the game, particularly if you use up all of your hand advantage. You can just draw two cards, obviously, off its effect later on down the line. Another card that can be quite expensive, but most of you hero players are used to spending a lot of money on weird cards. This is one of them. A Dusted Gold can obviously help you get down the lines of play that you need to for the likes of your Malicious Bane, something that you really want to be able to get into as and when you need to, and this card just helps you get there. If nothing else, it's a 2100 beater, which is nothing to sniff at. We have a single copy of Monster Reborn. It's the most generic extender in the world, but it is incredibly strong. And in this deck, where a lot of stuff can get benefits of being special summoned, this can have a massive advantage. We continue down our route of power spells here. We've got a single copy of Call by the Grave. If you could play more, you would. This deck can really suffer against hand traps. As a quick note, as you'll see here, we are omitting hand traps from this particular build. Ideally, we're going to go second with this. So you can play more of those if you so wish. I wanted to just focus on getting as many pieces into the deck as possible and as much consistency as you can. But in either case, Call by the Grave is really good defensively or offensively. It should go in first or second. What's not to like about that? A single copy of A Hero Lives. Honestly, paying half your life point, who fucking cares? You're probably going to win the game. Dark Calling, of course, is usually the card that you're going to search off your Dusted Gold. So just one copy of this is perfectly fine. Triple copies of Mass Change. This card is incredibly strong and usually going to lead to one of your win conditions. A lot of the time, if you can get this out and get Dark Lore onto the field, you're in an incredibly strong position. Triple copies of this are just fantastic. They very rarely cog as well because you can obviously just continue to use them. You can use them in battle phase, which is absolutely awesome from your hand. What's not to like about that? It can just help you get over that goddamn line. Fusion Destiny really doesn't cuck you all that much. You've got plenty of dark targets in here, so you don't have to worry about being locked in too much. And the fact that you can send stuff from your deck is really strong as well. Triple copies of this, in my opinion, need to be played. Miracle Fusion could be really good a little bit later on in the game, but honestly, even seeing this turn one with how quickly you can churn through your monsters, it really doesn't matter. It can put you in an incredibly strong position. Just the one copy here is plenty. A single copy of Polymerization, I'm not even going to discuss it. A single copy of Rota, I'm not even going to discuss it. Triple copies of Emergency Call, I'm not going to discuss it. Triple copies of Dark Roller No More, I'm not going to discuss it. And a single copy of Harpy's Feather Duster. I wouldn't discuss it, but honestly, a few people may frown at this one. So there was the ability to go for a 40-card deck here, but honestly, I felt like Harpy's Feather Duster is incredibly strong at the moment with the amount of back row heavy decks are in the format. Also, going second, you just want to kind of get rid of any options your opponent has to kind of cuck you or interrupt you. A lot of people at the moment are playing cards like Torrential Tribute, Solemn Strike, all of that. You want to be able to get rid of that and go about your plays as easily as possible, and Harpy's Feather Duster helps facilitate that. I didn't want to run too much other back row hate or anything like that, because if you come up against a deck where it doesn't do anything, then it's just another brick. But I think it's pretty safe to just play the single copy. And as with all of these videos, I'm not doing side deck coverage. You can watch plenty of videos out there that discuss side deck theory, because really it changes from deck to deck, from format to format, from where you're playing literally against another place. The room is filled with different decks and you want to preempt that a little bit as much as you can. With that in mind, we don't cover side decks usually on here, unless I'm doing a competitive list and we go through all of those details. So you've got a single copy of Malicious Bane. If you have access to it, you absolutely should play it. A single copy of Dystopia. I think this is a really solid card, and again, one that you need to be playing, but really we only have the space for the one. A single copy of Vision Hero Adoration. I really like this card in here. Some decks choose not to play it, but I think it, when you're going to try and OTK your opponent, this can really help you get there. Mass Hero Anki. We already know how strong this is. Some people, again, like to play multiple copies of this, but really I think that one is plenty. Masked Hero Acid, again, really strong at the moment because, well, there's so many back row decks. So many decks are benefiting from all of these torrential tributes and stuff. That honestly, having access to this to just nuke your opponent's back row is really, really strong. A single copy of Absolute Zero. This is one that can really cuck your opponent. It can be a really good defensive option. It can really leave your opponent in a really difficult position. Trinity, because we like to OTK. Sunrise can help facilitate OTKs as well as build up resources. I really like it in here. Not everyone decides to play this. That's entirely up to you. Honestly, I think that one copy in here is really nice. We have double copies of Dark Lore here. Honestly, this can be a win condition against so many decks. A lot of the time, if you can make this, you're basically set to win. So there's no reason not to play it. Destiny Hero Dangerous can be a really good option if you want to get Mali into Grave, amongst other things. But honestly, that's going to be your main target to send off of this. And then we move on to our link options here. Again, this extra deck is really tight, so you may want to adjust these a little bit depending on your personal flavor. But honestly, I think this is about right from my testing at least. So single copy of Dread Decimator, of course, being able to pump up an absolute ton of damage. Kind of suitable considering it looks like he's got a giant fucking dick pump in his hand. Two copies of Cross Crusader. This is usually part of that kind of link combo play that you go into in your turn one, particularly if you're going first. And Wonder Drive is just another good way to build up your resources and recur anything that you've used. And that brings us to a close on today's video. Hopefully, by virtue of the fact that you made it this far, if you weren't subscribed already, you absolutely are now. If you hadn't hit the notification bell already, you absolutely have now. Or maybe you just couldn't fucking look away from this weird goddamn face. In either case, I do appreciate you making it this far into the video. I really, really do. If you have enjoyed the content, or maybe you fucking hated it, let me know down in the comments. I do read most of them, and I'll probably just fucking block you if I don't like what you have to say. Again, deck profiles aren't all we do on the channel. We do how to play videos, combo tutorials, all that good stuff usually. Unfortunately, now is not the time for that sort of stuff. Again, I appreciate you sticking it out this far, and hopefully I'll see you in the next one. This content is brought to you in association with my buddies over at Jam Jam Cards UK. You can find the links to the eBay store and the Facebook page in the description.